How are you doing today, Alex?
Yeah, good, thanks. How are you doing, Ben?
Yeah, I'm really well. And so we're doing this episode to update people about what's been going on in your property business and your coaching business. What's the latest news?
Where do we start? So we have just had, well, your very own group go from Money Mastermind to Joint Venture Mastermind, which is, for me, the most exciting part, I think, to take you guys through a group that, you know, actually then goes to investing, because that's why ultimately we're all here. You know, the money bit's great and we've got to get it done, but it's really just an access to the next part. I've just finished chapter 12 of my book, which also means my online group are in week 12 of their online course and they're all rocking it. What else is going on? I've just started to continue my project, which is an end to homelessness, which is an all-encompassing, enormous goal that I'd kind of shelved for a bit and have sort of got back onto working on that again. So it's another sort of, I kind of, it's kind of, I have it that it's part of what I do, that as long as I'm a landlord and get people to be landlords, that while there are homeless people in existence, then we're somewhat failing. Is that correct? Yeah, not the existence of homeless people. Some people might want to be homeless and that's cool. But while there's the existence of people who are homeless, who feel like they can't get out of it and don't have access to getting into a home, I feel like that's, you know, that's on us as landlords. So that's something I'm choosing to take on at the moment. Had a really, really cool conversation with a guy from Oxford who's got a company called, or a charity called Greater Change, where they are using mobile phone apps to help homeless people save money to be able to get deposits for houses and all the rest of it. So solving all the problems that homeless people deal with, and also people who give to homeless people deal with, you know, the whole, oh, what are they going to spend the money on? You know, how do they save it? All the rest of it. So, yeah, super stoked about that.
So specifically, what does it allow them to do?
So specifically what it allows them to do is, if you imagine homeless people have no infrastructure, they have no address, they have no bank account. So what they struggle with, what the app does is it solves problems. So homeless people struggle with, actually, if you imagine everyone gives homeless people like a quid, 2 quid, at the end of the day, they have 100, 200 pounds. Now, if you've ever held that much money in coins, it's really heavy. So they have a physical issue with cash. The other thing that happens is people give homeless people food because they don't want to give them money to spend on drugs, which is a whole world there of like, it's up to them what they spend the money on. But what happens then, I've sat next to a homeless person before and they've been given like enough food for 10 days in an hour that I'm sat chatting to them. And what this app does, it resolves all that. So people can give to a homeless person without cash. And also they can trust that the homeless person is a genuine homeless person, not I can't remember the term for it, but someone pretending to be homeless who isn't really, they're just actually professional begging. It's all supported by caseworkers and it enables that homeless person to save money and to get money for the things that they need. And it can be anything from actual ID. So if you imagine homeless people, rarely they have next to nothing in what they carry, and they often get robbed quite frequently. So they lose what they have, the little that they have as well. So sometimes just as something as simple that you or I, you know, we go, oh, we need a passport, it's 75 quid, we'll just get one. That is like an enormous challenge for them, and it's an enormous challenge for the people that help them. So they end up just not being able to get ID, which means they can't then get housing. It's just this vicious circle of shit circumstance that doesn't allow anything to happen. So this app builds the availability of funds, and the and being able to have access to funds means access to things like housing. Once they've got housing, then they can get all the rest of it. And it's effectively something that I'd been kind of thinking about, but not done anything about. And then when I started looking into actually doing it, someone's already doing it. So I'm going to help, you know, where I can with the guys at Greater Change to make it basically more accessible and rolled out. They've done it in Oxford and Chichester so far, but it's not rolled out into the UK.
So is it actually on the App Store? Like, can we download it now?
So no, that's the issue with it. They haven't got that far with it. So I've got further meetings with them to find out how we do it and how, say, for example, what I'd like to do is I'd like to trial being an ambassador for them to bring it to Newport and Cardiff to then roll it out and see how it works, what doesn't work, and work at, you know, really making it effectively the Airbnb for homeless people. And I don't mean in the sense they can get a room, but Airbnb came in to the hotel industry with no infrastructure and just went, we're going to solve a problem and put people together. And I believe this app has the potential to be that, to connect all the existing charities and services for homeless people, the people who want to give and donate and sponsor, and the actual homeless people. So it's like there are three different sectors in this so-called housing crisis, which are people who want to donate and sponsor, the charities that are already on the ground, and the actual clients, the homeless people. And at the moment, there's nothing that joins them all up. So it's all kind of everyone's trying really hard to do stuff, but it doesn't really work very well in an entire picture for getting someone out of actual homelessness. And this app in the last year with what they've done in Oxford with the charity that is supporting them, Aspire in Oxford, have worked with them. They've got 20 people actually out of homelessness through this process.
Mm. Yeah. So cool stuff.
Pretty cool.
How do we stay updated? Should we just keep an eye on what you're doing?
So that's a really good question, actually. And it's one of the conversations. So Alex is the guy who's developed this app. And that's the one thing that I said to him on the phone call this week. I was like, we need to be able to follow you. So I'm encouraging him to create a video blog on YouTube about it. I'll have further conversations. If he won't, then maybe that's something that we can kind of have as a little side video about, like updates about what's happening, to basically get the message out. Because at the moment, they're struggling to get people on board, which I think is insane when there's as much will and want to do what there is out there. It's mad that they have to talk charities into using their app when they solve the problem of repeated homelessness. You know, someone kind of coming into a shelter, then going out, then coming back and never actually leaving the system. It costs a huge amount of money. So I'll keep you updated and we'll see where it goes. I've literally just had the first conversation with Alex this week.
So. Okay. All right, then. To be continued. So you've,
to be continued indeed.
You've added, so there's a couple of things I want to touch on. So I'm part of one of your coaching groups. And as you said at the start, we've just finished like the intro period of 4 months and we're transitioning into the investing period, which I kind of like from where I'm at, I find it hard to believe we're going to start investing in property. It feels like to me, it feels still a bit unreal, if that makes sense. Now, I know from your perspective, you've been doing it a long time and you've got a different point of view on it. And I guess, so that's interesting, you know. And you've started like an online coaching group for property investing. So tell us about that.
So the online version is what you've just done, but purely online. So instead of you guys, like you come to me once a month and we hang around my kitchen table or garden table as it was last month because it was so nice and sunny. I'm actually doing it online. And I've really resisted doing this for a long time because I kind of think, I like being in person and all the rest of it. And basically I got to a point where I couldn't take any more clients on. And the only way to keep helping people was to try something online. And this is a good example of how helpful coaches are. I've had coaches for years saying to do this and I've resisted it and said no and made excuses and avoided it and all the rest of it. And it's been the best thing I could have ever done because it's forcing me to kind of write everything down. So I've just literally spent this morning writing chapter 12 with Sarah, my PA. So my brain is a little bit frazzled at the moment and it's literally like getting everything out of my head onto paper, which means it's accessible to more people, which means that now actually if someone said, well, I want to do the self-study program, it's there and it's available. And what it means is there are actual PDFs and there are actual videos and actual calls that happen, not without me because I'm on the coaching calls, but once I've done all the actual material, it just means it's accessible and it's making me better and it's making me more to the point and consistent and helpful. Making me focus on what works, what doesn't work, and really kind of nailing my subject, I guess, is the best way to describe it. These guys are in week 12, so they've got 4 more weeks to go. It's pretty intense doing it online. I kind of had it that it would be easier. It's actually harder because I have 10 people on the online course, whereas when I'm dealing with you guys, there were 6, and some of the other groups, there's 4. So it's kind of double the amount of people I'm used to having. And they have an hour and a half call a week. They have an email out of a video and a PDF on a Monday, a call on a Wednesday evening. And then they have their own group. So they're split into subgroups. So there's 4 people and 6 people in the groups within the online group, if that makes sense.
Right.
We're all connected by WhatsApp group. So anyone who's got a question in the week or struggling or stuck on anything can kind of send a message out and can either get help from other people on the course or from me, depending on what it is. And some of them have some extra coaching. So I do bolt-on coaching for people who've got specific stuff that they want to deal with. So they have like half an hour, like just drilling down on what it is they're dealing with to move them through it.
Mm. And just to be clear, like I know what you teach, but just to clarify for people that don't, what do people come away with?
Okay. So people come to me stuck with money, or come to me with thoughts of there must be something more because working in this job and never having any money really sucks. They kind of hear about property and how successful it is, but they can't imagine doing it. I have quite a few people that come to me who have done a lot of property courses already and still don't own a single property. So they've spent thousands, 12, 15, 20,000 on property, so-called mentoring, and haven't bought a thing. So I deal with people who are stuck like that. They still know that it's possible, but they still haven't figured out their stuff. People who are in debt, who want to get out of debt, people who have maybe had an inheritance, but don't know what the hell to do with it and know that if they just spend it, it'll just be gone. So they come to me feeling kind of stuck, confused, unsure, not really very confident. And what I teach is the mechanics and the mindset of it and of money. And more specifically, I get them to figure out what their stuff is. So I don't just, I mean, you know this, Ben, from being on the live course, right? And the online's the same. I don't just go, well, here's a load of material. This is how you do money. Off you go, which is what most courses do. I go, well, okay, let's have a look. What are you dealing with? Why are you the way you are? What's actually going on? What do you really need? What do you really want? So we spend a huge amount of the course answering the question, what do you want? And most people, I say, well, what do you want? And people are like, literally, they don't know what they want, right?
But in Alex's coaching, nothing gets swept under the rug. Nothing. If you think you're going to get away without talking about your relationship with your partner, your childhood, you know, why you're angry at your mum or your dad or whatever happened, you know, you're not going to get away with none of that. Everything gets addressed. Now, why is that? Why is that important?
Because that's the reason that people aren't succeeding. So it's like literally, it's not even just the rug, it doesn't get swept up, the rug gets lifted and like shaken out and beaten with a stick, right? To follow that analogy through, like literally nothing is left. That's the reason why people's stuff don't work. So if people think they don't have to deal with their childhood to move forward in their adult life, they're just, I mean, it's not even a woo-woo thing to say that anymore. It's just known.
Why? Why is it important and why does it hold people back?
So the first 7 years, so the best, the most concise person, if you want to like, you know, if anyone wants to like look more into this to think, oh, what's she on about? She doesn't know what she's on about. Go and listen to Bruce Lipton is my favorite guy at the moment, who really explains that from 0 to 7, we are like sponges that are programmed to be the way that people in our environment are. So it's usually our mum and dad. So like, it's a bit of a joke, isn't it? Like, oh, mummy and daddy issues. But it's literally like, well, we spent the first 7 years of our lives literally watching every single thing that our mums and dads did, imprinting it on our brain. And we spend the rest of our lives reliving those imprints unless we choose to do something different. So anyone that is not functioning in any area, so someone might be really successful in every area except relationships, or they might be really successful at relationships but shit at money, that, you know, there'll be something from childhood that is programmed to basically be unworkable.
Let me tell people, it's like when we get on the conference calls with Alex once a week, she straight up says, don't tell me what's going well, tell me what's going wrong and we'll work on that. Because because there's a habit of, yeah, everything's fine, yeah, business is good, I'm okay, things are all right. And she's like, scrap that, we're doing the opposite. What isn't going well and what do we need to improve? Tell me what isn't working this week.
Yeah, and that's it. Because it's like, I don't want to brush over people's successes, but there's just nothing there for me. It's like, great, you did well. What do we want to look at? Whereas you tell me what's not going right, like the fight that you had with your partner, or the fact that you haven't spoken to your mum for 3 years, or the fact that, you know, whatever it is, I don't know, you're in loads of debt and you haven't told anyone. Mm. There's some work we can do there. Like, we can get freedom there. We can go from like a shit pit into like, woohoo, up to the skies and, you know, happy days. There's so much freedom there.
What's your point of view? Because some people say you should focus on the positive and not focus on like the negative. So what do you say to that?
How's it working for you? Probably not. Like, literally anyone that goes, oh, let's just focus on the positive. It's like, well, okay, tell me how your life is. And the minute I say to someone, well, tell me how your life's going, and they tell me all the positive stuff, and then I go, and what about this? And what about this? And what about this? And then they go, oh, yeah. Like, it just doesn't work. It, like, just pretend. I think the problem with positive thinking is that it doesn't work. It's like pretending everything's okay when it's not. You know, what works is acknowledging what is, being honest about that, shining a light on it, and then moving on. It's not about digging through the dirt or, you know, really going there or reliving trauma. It's not, but we've at least got to acknowledge what happened. And like, for anyone who's watching this going, well, my childhood was fine, I'm not talking about major trauma. You know, major trauma in some ways, and again, people who have had major trauma who are watching this, don't get upset. Like, just don't make it mean that your trauma is not, you know, worthy, okay? But major trauma is easy to distinguish. If someone's been punched in the face, they know they've been punched in the face, and they can go, yeah, I've got a fear of X, Y, and Z because I was punched in the face. If someone has had a childhood where they weren't really allowed to show any emotion, or it kind of wasn't okay to ask for what they wanted, or they had things around them like being told, oh, money doesn't grow on trees, or they had a dad who was never there, who was always out working really hard to provide for the family, they're going to have some stuff there that doesn't serve them when they're older. But it's really hard to figure it out, because how it occurs is, well, my childhood was fine. There was nothing really wrong with my childhood. And that is way more complex to deal with than out and out trauma.
Mm. That's the irony with stuff that's in your own blind spot, isn't it? Yeah. You're not aware of it. And that's why having a coach or a mentor is so powerful, because they're going to shine a light on stuff that you don't usually think about.
And a coach, you know, over time, I think the more and more I work with people, the more I work with people for the long term. And I work with my coach, you know, for the long term as well. And it's about, if we flit from different people, and I'm not saying you don't, like, I don't expect people to work with me like from now till the day they die, but I need a substantial amount of time to really create lasting change and to really work through the stuff. Because stuff, you can change in a heartbeat, and then life's going to come back in, and you're going to have to deal with stuff again. You know, there are levels to which we deal with stuff, and nothing ever goes away. You know, our childhoods don't just magically disappear, but we learn how to deal with ourselves and what we need to deal with. And having a coach over the long term really helps, because I remember what people say.
Yeah, I know you do.
Yeah, I was going to say, like, you know, we could pick a few examples right from the group where, you know, I remember what people say, and I remind them of that. So it's, and that's what's really powerful as well.
Mm. So in terms of the actual property deals that your students or clients, whatever they are doing.
Clients, yeah.
Clients. What's going on? Like, how many projects have happened under your mentorship?
Good question. This is where everyone be like, oh, is it 50 or 60? And I'll be like, I don't know, it was maybe 7 or 8. So we've been going, people into joint venture mastermind 2 years. We're in 2 years. I've got one group that's 3 years old now. And one group that's about a year old. And then the rest are like, you guys are coming into joint venture mastermind, right? And so the one group, I think they've probably got 4 or 5 properties in their portfolio, the first one. They've done one refurb from like auction to refurb to rental. They've had some real messes that they've cleared, not real messes. They've had some stuff to clear up from their own portfolios. And then they are currently looking at auction properties and Rightmove properties now to do their next deal. So that's one group. So it depends. This is a really interesting question, because the ego part of me wants to go, oh yeah, we've done loads of stuff and it's really cool. And actually what's so is that it's a really long, slow burn at the beginning, right? So what happens is everyone has to deal with their personal shit, and then everyone has to deal with the group shit, and then everyone has to get to a point where they're saving enough to be able to buy a property. So I kind of love and hate this question. So I love this question because it gets to the truth of how it is in property, and I hate it because fear of looking bad. It sounds really slow. So what it does is, what happens with the groups is it takes time to kind of save up the money and build to buy the first property, and then that money gets reinvested, and that money gets reinvested to the point where it escalates that it's very fast. And at the moment, the groups that are with me are like in the really growing stage. Mm-hmm. So yeah, that group has done an actual bought in auction remortgaged it and have rented it out. And I think they've got three or four properties that they kind of had between them as single buy to lets that weren't working. One guy had one that, you know, it'd been empty for a year and he'd not done anything with it. So they've put it into the company and it's rented and cash flowing well. And I think there's two or three that are either in or going in. And they've also bought, or in the process of buying from Wayne in your group, actually, an HMO that's ready done. So they're going to have about six properties in their company within the next month or so. And they're now buying somewhere, or they're looking for somewhere, have been for the last 2 months, either at auction or Rightmove, with one of my other groups, Abundant Assets, who there's two ladies in that group. So I've got the four in the one and the two in the other, and they're going to do a JV. So this is where it gets kind of even more fun. It's not just your group, it's who you can be with the other groups as well. And with the six of them together, I've split them into two groups, and they've got a Rightmove group and an auction group, and they're in competition to see who can basically buy a property first. So the auction is on the 13th of June, and the Rightmove group are basically set the challenge of finding an offering on a house before the 13th of June. And over the weekend, while I was camping, I was watching. I have groups for all my group chats for all my groups, so I can keep an eye on what's going. And whilst I was camping at the weekend, I was watching the JV group, and they've found two properties on Rightmove that they really like the look of, and they've put offers in, and I've yet to hear whether they've had those offers accepted. So that's like happening now, and the auction guys will still keep going and doing all the due diligence to get to auction, but whether or not they actually get to bid on anything is another thing.
So we'll see. People listening to this, they're going to be curious about getting involved. So, and they're going to be thinking, like, how much money do I need to get involved with this? Like, how much is your coaching cost? How much of a deposit do I need to invest in property? So what's the answer to that?
So the answer is, it's like ridiculously simple. This will sound me. And some people will be like, the cheapest property coaching you've ever had. So
Alex,
it's £250 a month. Yeah,
it just cut out just as you started talking. Just so,
Let's start again.
Yeah, go again. Say exactly the same again. Yeah.
Okay, cool. So it's really, really simple how you can work with me. And to some people, this will sound really expensive and unaffordable. And to people who have looked into other property stuff, it'll seem like the craziest, cheapest property coaching you've ever done. So it's £250 a month to work with me. Which equates to £3,000 a year, and it may be ongoing for a few years. So it's important to like really understand the investment, right? The first 4 months is £1,000, and people may or may not then go into investing in property. So it's a kind of, it's a really small way to start and figure out if you like me, if it works, if it's what you want to carry on doing and all the rest of it. From an investment point of view after that, it's actually, it might be as little as 50 quid a month. So it really depends. So what I say to people is, if people haven't got a lump sum or any more than the 250 a month, at this stage, it doesn't matter, because that's what we answer in Money Mastermind. We answer like, how's your money working? How could it work better? How can we increase your income? How can we reduce your expenses to create the money to then invest in the properties? So when you look at it like that, £3,000 a year, it's not a lot to get involved in property. And when there are courses out there charging 10, 15, 20,000 for a year, and then they dump you out the other side having not bought a property, it's crazy cheap. If you are, you know, on a wage where all of your money is taken up by expenses, I got that seems expensive. If that's the case, it's one of the reasons I'm writing the book, to make it accessible for people to kind of get to the stage where they've got that money. But if you look, if you're listening to this going, there's no way I can afford 250 a month, I would suggest that that's not true. And I would suggest that if you hustled a bit and sold some of that stuff you've got that you never use, and if you got a little part-time job or you did some extra hours, 250 actually is not that big a leap. It's about £56 a week or something. Okay. 50 quid a week. Could you manage that if you really pushed? If you really like, this is about, do you want to be financially free? At that point, 50 quid a week's not a lot. To get you the access to get to the higher stuff, to earn more money, to build, you know, the guys in Joint Venture Mastermind, we're building businesses as well. This isn't just about buying property. This is about increasing income and building dream businesses. So I think probably all of my clients, without exception, have raised their income since being on the course. So I far out earn myself, if that makes sense. You get way back, way more back than the £3,000 a year. than that you put in the first place. So
yeah, I've done your 4 month intro for £1,000, and I got no hesitation that it's worth it, none at all. So anybody listening to this, yeah,
thanks, Ben.
So, have you got room for more people?
I do in September. So there's basically a waiting list system in between courses. So I will start another online course in September. So we're at June now. And I will take a maximum. And I even, when I say this, I think, oh, can we do 20? And I think, yes, we can handle 20, but no more. So an absolute maximum of 20 so that I can make sure I take care of everyone. And within that, I think what's really important for everyone to know is that you can bring people that you already want to work with. So I have one group that's made up of two couples and they're already friends. And they come on the course to like do it together. So they're already kind of flying along on the online course because there's no getting to know each other. If you're coming to this on your own and you've got no one that you know that you want to work with, then I will put you in a group. And at the moment it works in the UK, right? So I've got, well, one of the guys in your group comes from Scotland. I've got a few people who come from London. I've got a few people who come from Bristol, Stroud. I'm in Newport. We've got some other people from Cardiff. So it can work kind of UK wide. I'm hesitant to say it can, you know, go any further than that at the moment because we're investing in UK property ultimately. But if people are listening to this and they're not in the UK and they thought, well, I just want to get my money sorted, or they thought, well, I can get together a group of between, and I think 3 to 6 works, there's the potential that they could do this in their own country following the program, if that makes sense. It's going to be a whole nother world of, you know, they're going to have to deal with their own property laws and stuff, but it's doable.
Okay. All right. So anybody who's curious, they should, email you?
They can. Yes, that's a good question.
Or go to the website, financialfreedomwithalex.com.
So they can either email me directly or they can go to the website and book a clarity call. If they just want a straight sign up, they can sign up and buy it on the website straight away if they know that's for them. You know, if you've listened to enough of my stuff to think, yeah, I resonate with you, I want in, then they can literally just go to the website, press buy, buy the Money Mastermind course and sign up, and it'll be for the September. So we start in September. Everything's recorded, so if there are any dates that are an issue, then it's not a problem that the recordings come out. I do request that most people make most of the calls most of the time, otherwise it's not going to work for you. If you're going to sign up and pay the £1,000, that's just like, it's not even 1% of the course. You know, the course is about showing up and doing the work and doing the exercises. So if there are people that are listening to this and they're like, hey, do you know what I want in, that's it. And once it's full, it's full, and then there'll be another waiting list. And just so everyone really gets how well I kind of plan ahead, I'm planning on getting pregnant as well at the end of this year, so when the next one will be, I actually don't know.
Everything's in the diary. Pregnancy's in the diary.
Literally. So just so that everyone really gets this, because this is what I also invite everyone to work towards, I'm doing Tough Mudder in August, I think it is, when we're all doing, the ones of us that are doing Tough Mudder, we're doing Tough Mudder, and then I'm going to stop, you know, trying not to get pregnant, if that makes sense. And it's really, it sounds daft, but people don't plan like this, and then they wonder why their lives don't work. And so that everyone really gets what they get when they get with me, I'm just like, this is the way it is.
This is what
I'm,
she's like,
pregnant then.
She's figured out she wants 4 kids by a certain age. In order to do that, you've got to have one every couple of years.
If you're saying that as a joke, I literally did this with my coach.
Yeah.
And I want 3 children. And by 2026, I want the youngest one to be going to primary school. I'm not shitting you. I literally have done this, because then when that happens, I can buy my farm. Because I'll have time and headspace to deal with buying my farm.
And this is the kind of, this is the way Alex coaches as well. She makes us all sort of write specifically what we want and then work backwards. Right, what has to happen for that to happen?
Do what I teach, right? I don't just tell you guys to do it because it's a good idea. I literally do it myself. So my world is planned. And for anyone going, oh my God, that sounds so like controlled and planned and boring. It's like, well, have a look at the last 10 years of your life and how well's it gone. And if it hasn't gone that well, then I invite you to try this because it works. And for anyone going, yeah, but what if you don't get pregnant? It's like, well, we'll deal with it when it happens, but let's plan for how we want it. And then if something doesn't happen, let's deal with it rather than just going, well, it might not happen, therefore I'll not plan. So I'll just sit and watch EastEnders.
There you have it, folks. So you're... You've got stuff to do now, haven't you? So I'm going to let you go.
Thank you very much. Yes, I actually have the rest of that chapter to finish writing, do a video, and then send it off to my online people so we can have a call on Wednesday.
How many chapters will it be in total?
16. So we're nearly there. So actually, if anyone is watching this and going like, oh my God, I'm not waiting until September. That's like an age away, which it kind of is, right? And you want to get it done during the summer. There is a way on my website you can book the self-study program, and you will get all the videos, all the content weekly, mind, because I want to make sure you do the exercises. You can have it weekly immediately, so you don't get all the content at once. You'll get it sent out to you weekly, and you also have the opportunity to buy my time with bolt-on coaching at a discounted rate. For anyone who comes into my programs can then have one-to-one time at £75 for half an hour, and it's normally £125 for half an hour. So if anyone really like is just like, oh, I just want to get going, and I want, or I've got a group and I want to, you know, work with them, buy the self-study program. I will send it out to you, and then if you want to have one-to-one actual time with me, then you can buy it. So yes,
get your wallets out, folks, get involved. Would you want to make
get
money
your
or don't
out
you
and get rich, right, and get wealthy? It's like, why wait? Like,
yeah,
really, why wait?
Yeah. Yeah.
And for anyone else who's like, oh, I'm not sure, it sounds like a lot of money, I have 100% money back guarantee. If you do this and it doesn't work for you, you can have your money back, because it works, right? And as yet, I've only ever had one person come back and say, can I have my money back? And when I actually spoke to them about what was wrong, I found out they weren't having enough coaching. So they were a one-to-one client. So I have this promise across the board. Like, if you work with me, that's it. If it's not working, you have your money back. And they came to me and said, this isn't working. And when I sent them all their money back for everything they'd had so far. And then I said, now, can we have a conversation about why it wasn't working in a clean space? You've had your money back. You've got nothing to lose. You're not trying to like fight me for, you know, your money back or whatever. I just want to know what didn't work for you so that I can make sure that doesn't happen again. They are now in my joint venture mastermind program, and have been. They ended up spending more money with me because what we figured out was it wasn't enough help, and they felt lost and like I wasn't taking care of them. So like, really get that this stuff works. And if it doesn't, there's no risk. You can have your money back. I'm not interested in working with people who believe that the stuff isn't working. And if I don't resonate with you or something happens, you know, and you come to me, you know, and say, this just isn't working, I go, cool, have your money back. It's not why I do this. You know, I do this to actually create change. It's not for the money. I charge money because I have to value my time, and I have to have a way of, you know, sort of self-sorting who works with me. And the people that pay me to work with me, they value it so much more. And also, what's really key for anyone listening to this, you're not actually paying me, you're paying yourselves. You're buying yourselves, like, I don't know, if you go out for a meal, you're buying yourself a meal, and this is no different.
I'm buying myself an early retirement.
Yeah, like literally. And it's probably about as cheap as it gets for early retirement. I invite people to look at what else is out there and see. And I don't actually know how many other people are doing this kind of program that is that handheld and that kind of inclusive in the property world. There are coaches out there who, you know, get massive results for people over time, for sure. This isn't about coaches, but it's about in the property world. This is like, we have 100% success rate. Everyone that's in the teams are moving forward and getting where they need to go.
Good stuff. Boom, have it.
Come sort your life out.
All right, so that's financialfreedomwithalex.com.
Yeah, that's the one.
All right. All right then, Alex, thanks for your time.
Thanks, man. Catch you soon.
All right, see you soon. Bye.
Bye.